Hello everyone, Thayne here, Director of Mulcahy & Co Financial Planning. Today I was going to discuss the topic of superannuation, compare the pair. Obviously there's many different superannuation funds out there, so probably 200 in excess, which is always gives some people some stress of whether they're in the right superannuation fund. So this is a service that Mulcahy & Co Financial Planning help clients with every day. Typically there's industry superannuation funds, retail superannuation funds, employer or corporate superannuation funds, and self-managed super funds. So each of those super funds have different advantages and disadvantages, and really the suitability for each individual will depend on their life stage, individual requirements for investment menus, insurance cover, etc. There's generally three fee structures associated with all of those superannuation funds. So the first generally being that there's an administration fee. So an administration fee is generally paid for, be it statements, being able to access an investment menu, and despite most investors not being aware of it or not having to be involved in it, each year your super fund will have to do an annual tax return and audit based on the income, the capital that's been received, insurance premiums, etc. So the superannuation funds, of whether it's Rest Superannuation, Colonial First State, whoever it may be, they all have to do this, and they all charge a fee for providing those services. The second fee then comes down to your investment selection. So your investment selection can range, be it from purely cash or term deposits, to Australian shares, international shares, as well as property. So this is where an advisor typically works with the client to work out, well, what preferences they have and the reasons for it, to tailor an investment strategy or solution to the individual, which will also take into account the client's stage of life, whether they're a young individual starting out in their working life, or a mature couple who are putting kids through school and just concentrating on paying down debt, or those that are approaching retirement and in retirement. And so depending on your stage of life, as you can appreciate or understand, you'll have different requirements or wants or needs from a superannuation fund. And this is where, once again, an advisor can sit down with you and help explain and determine which would be the most suitable. So as you could also appreciate, just to cover off on it, if you're investing in cash and term deposits, generally there is no cost for doing this. As most individuals would be aware, if they have cash or term deposits with their own bank, they're not paying investment fees as such for this. However, when you start to invest in shares and property, etc., the transaction costs obviously increase. So as you get aware with the property, there's stamp duty, which is paid to the state government when that type of thing happens, or when buying and selling shares, there's brokerage. So depending on your allocation and which investments you're selecting, then the cost will obviously change as a result. The third fee structure is then the advisor fee. So this fee will cover off on the recommendations, the planning, the appointments, putting in place and implementing a strategy, which will obviously be offset by tax savings and wealth creation, etc., and even your emotional benefits of feeling confident and in control and understanding of where you're going, and that your retirement plans are on track. So take this into account and understand this when analysing your superannuation fund statements, because they will all charge fees. Yes, some will vary over others, but it's really then dependent on the benefits and the services and the features and the functionality that you're getting access to. And so if you are receiving statements where your superannuation fund has potentially lost money or gained money, try and understand that this is being generated or as a result of the investment that you're selected within your superannuation fund. Now, research and statistics will show that 80% of individuals don't research or analyze their superannuation fund. And this is where I feel a lot of people get themselves into trouble, is because they'll say, my super fund has performed good or it hasn't, without understanding what investment they've selected. And it's really because 80% of them have never analyzed what investment option that there is, or what investment option they're using. This is once again where an advisor can help you to select what investment would be most suitable for you, given your stage of life and your comfort levels, etc. So hopefully this gives you a good understanding and appreciation of how superannuation works and the different fee structures, as well as the functionality. If you feel that it'd be benefit for you to catch up and analyze this and go through it, by all means, please feel free to call the office to make a time with one of our advisors to be able to sit down and analyze this with you.